And the thing is, Ravel's piano writing, I mean, it's just all these beautiful 13 arpeggiata chords. It's so gorgeous, it's so chocolate. But it will slow you down. It's sort of like if you stop and smell every single flower, like I want to in this campus, I'm never going to get anywhere. So let's pick a better tempo. There's plenty of times when he writes on poetry, right? Plenty of times. He's given you, he was a master orchestrator. How do you feel about? Interesting because you're sort of stuck in this idea. Can you play please from a tempo? Things that we call hairpins. You know, there's no adequate way to say hairpin in Russian. It's a fantastic language, at least they wouldn't say, but not one way to adequately say crescendo and diminuendo. In English, it's just very clear, hairpin. There's no hairpin. In other words, you're playing piano. Like, a pianist would not be able to do this. Right here. So this B, so on the oboe, we have good notes and bad notes. A bad note is a note that just naturally wants to sound bright, thin, weak, and it's not really manageable for air production. B natural is unfortunately such a note. And some of our colleagues make the artistic choice to only do what sounds good on the instrument. The payoff of that is that you always sound good. It's sonically very good quality playing. Unfortunately, it doesn't always line up with what the composer wants. You want to bloom on this note and be natural. So how can we bloom on a note that's resisting power, doesn't really get wide and thin? What can we do to bloom on it? We have to start less. Exactly. Ben studied with me. I'm going to remind you of my philosophy on vibrato. There are three kinds of vibrato, at least. What are they?
Low,
pass,
something in between.
Oh, gee. Well, you sort of remember. Sort of is a funny word in the music business. You sort of get the job. You sort of win. We will sort of pay you. So, I love Ben. It's just I can give him a hard time because I've known him longer. But so, okay, let's just revisit this. So we have this magical thing called vibrato on the oboe, like on the voice. So three different kinds: slow and wide,
fast and shallow.
Well, I'm sorry, slow and wide.
Cello on the C string, violin on the G string, really wide, colossal, titanic, heavens are coming down, that kind of a regard. Shallow,
fast and shallow.
Fast and shallow. Can you demonstrate fast and shallow?
What piece of that?
I've got another. I know, but okay. That's what I meant by demonstrate. Choose a good place to do it. Can you think of one? I've got a good one. So, in the magic figure, there's one aria called Voi che sapete cosa è l'amore.
In B flat major. Go away.
Thank you. excitement to the note that must happen right away. You don't have time. It's very intense. If you overdo it, that's like drinking 10 cups of espresso and being plugged in as an American appliance in the European voltage. That's, they just sound like that. It's not sustainable. And then you serve one in a minute, right? And then there's secret option number four, non vibrato, because in the oboe, we don't have to use the same amplitude of vibrato from start to finish. We can start non vibrato. Then we can warm it up with intensity and the voluptuous, gorgeousness, chocolatiness, and then the other way. So the reason for the speech is that this variety is not enough. The variety of vibrato that you have is not enough. Everything else is absolutely gorgeous. Let's go from